Well, Chief, what do you got for me? You must be a smooth talker. Come on, Delvin, get these bracelets of yours off me.
You're sure to regret this. This tiefling will fleece you for everything you've got. Mark my words.
You're a bitter little man, Delvin. Petty and mean. You can't even be happy for me, can ya? I pity you. I'll leave you alone with your sad little soul. So long. And now, Chief, straight down to business. You see, I'm one of those guys that people around here call thieflings. We just call ourselves the family. After we knocked over that shop and I got stuck here in the Defender's Heart, a little bird told me that Big Sister Charisma wanted to see me. That she had some questions to ask me. You following? Now, she won't be asking me questions like, Woljif, how'd you manage to get out of this one? Or, Woljif, you're so thin, didn't they feed you? No, something serious has gone down, and I just know they want to try to pin something on me. I can feel it in my tail. So, I knew right away that I couldn't go alone. You turned up just in time, Chief. You don't need to do anything when we get there. Just stand behind me and look mean, and I'll handle the rest. Somehow. Let's go, I'll show you the way.
I'll go ahead.
The last one for me.
You crossed the wrong mongrel.
I know the way.
You won't survive me.
Cover me, all right?
follow my lead.
Hello? Is anyone there? Please get me out of here! I can hear your footsteps!
Free at last. I thought I'd be flattened like a pancake under that rubble. Much obliged. Damn, I'm not in any pain, but my head is still foggy for some reason. What's with all the hubbub in the city? The name's Finian. I'm a Pathfinder. If there's anything I can do to help, I will. That's right, Finian Dismar, Pathfinder and Crusader. I roam around the world wound wherever my tasks lead me. Scouting, mostly. But this last while, I've just been hanging around in Canabras, waiting until I'm needed again. I'm bored out of my mind, but at least this shop makes for better lodging than some inn. What's that supposed to mean? I just told you. You want to know where I hail from, is that it? Well, I'm from around here, actually. We Kellets of the Star Eye clan fled when the World Wound troubles began. But I couldn't stand by while the demons wreaked havoc, so I came back. Or did you mean to ask about my weapon of choice? My best weapon is every weapon. I'm a skilled and capable fellow, if I do say so myself. I can swing a sword and poke with a spear, but what I am best at is communing with the spirits. They call folks like me Phantom Blades. It's like a spiritualist, but with a twist. It means that some spirit took a liking to me at some point, and it can turn into whatever weapon I need. Handy, eh? I don't need any whetstones or enchantments. Doesn't take up space either. Although, to be fair, it's not a barrel of laughs. The spirits that bestow this kind of power don't come from happy places, and they're not exactly bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. They usually appear after great battles that leave few survivors. Wait, what? The last thing I saw was some thieves breaking in here. And then the guards came, everyone was running around. After that, it's a bit of a blur. Right when things got intense, they dropped the cabinet on me. I couldn't even help the owner. I was just lying under the shelves like a dimwit until you came along. If there are demons in Canabras, we must do something about it. The city needs every blade it can get. Hey, do you mind taking me with you? I don't think I can handle this alone. And besides, the more the merrier. I've been waiting here so long, I don't even remember anymore. Just sitting and waiting for any word from the Pathfinders, but it looks like everyone has forgotten about me. The shop owner is an old friend of the Pathfinders, so I've taken up residence here. I swear you won't regret it. I can do all sorts of things. Is there anything your party is missing? A sword, a spear, a bow? Just say the word.
know what to do.
I found... something?
Who, me?
Thanks, Lan. You're so awesome, Lan.
I am helpful, am I not? what is that? I hope you appreciate this. What's on your mind? I wonder.
Can't hide from me.
Look, Chief, I got something to show you. Ta-da!
A real beaut, isn't it?
Oh, that cuts me deep, Chief. You and I saw who the traitor was. It's just that when we robbed the shop, I went in first and took what I wanted. Nothing wrong with that. Although, of course, I did think about hiding the moon and just taking myself off somewhere warm when all this blows over. But only because I want to see the world. Is it a crime to want to travel, huh? Is that what counts for treachery these days? Since that night, Chief, Melram didn't even set eyes on it. While he was dealing with the golem, I sneaked past them, and that was that. Do you really not remember it? Oh, I thought you would appreciate it. It's from the old man Fileman, the owner of the Ancient Trees and Wonders shop. It's the pride of his collection. The Moon of the Abyss, an amulet with a rare crystal crafted by an unknown maker. When I think of how much this thing is worth, it makes my head spin. Thieves have their ways. What? So she would slay me right away, you mean? You saw how antsy she was over Canabris and all this. So I did it. I took the Moon of the Abyss. But I didn't go to Erebeth, and Big Sister wouldn't hear my explanations. She doesn't have the time. I even thought I'd hide the moon somewhere, and then when all the noise had died down, I'd go get it and make a run for it. I'm sick of the thieflings, and they never appreciated me anyway. Why, he asks? It's expensive, pretty. And you know, it's my amulet, actually. Not meaning I stole it, but I mean, this is my inheritance. My grandma and I were poor. All we had was a jewelry box with the moon in it. She used to store it under the floor in the basement, and she'd take it out sometimes just to look at it. She was always nicer when she had a few drinks in her, so I could ask her things then. One time I asked where she got it from, and she said it was from a demon. You know, the demon who was my grandfather. He said the moon was to be passed down. My ma was good for nothing and nobody, so that's why Grandma decided to keep the amulet for me. She used to say it would be mine when I grew up, but she couldn't wait until I grew up. She squandered my inheritance when she became a drunk. Took it to Fileman's shop and pawned it. He gave her some coppers for it, and she didn't even haggle. Just grabbed them and ran back to the tavern before last orders. I've been going to Fileman's to look at the moon ever since I was a kid. He chased me away, but I just kept going back, so eventually he gave up. He didn't skimp on security. The place was like a fortress, so he wasn't worried about a street rat like me pinching anything. Even when I got more skilled, I couldn't get any closer to it. One day, I had no one to go with. Another day, there were only oafs who'd never stolen anything more than a church donation box. But when Charisma had planned everything out, I realized I had a chance to get the moon and move away from here. Maybe to Garand. I hear it's warmer there. I've stayed with the family for too long. Allies, friends, it's all a load of crap. Life brings us together, forces us to make plans, do whatever it is we do, but it's a safe bet that this ain't forever. I might be a traitor, but the others, what, are they any better than me? Melround had a good reputation in the family. He was trusted, and you see what happened. If you abide by the law, anyone can rob you. So you need to break the law first when no one expects it, and run before you go soft and get too attached. Whatever you think, I owe you. I'm not just a thief. I have my own business selling things. Thanks to you, I'm still in the family. And they... Well, I mean, we have the black market sewn up in this city. It's a good way to sell valuables. So, if you need anything, a scroll or something, just say the word. I have a little portal to our people in Erosion. You put a note there, and you get what you need. I can't get you anything big, but what they do have is all high quality. Nothing's too good for you, Chief. What's mine is yours. For a price, of course.